float as positive or negative or zero. When we have total float value is negative, it means that the project completion is behind the scheduled data. Resources are not adequate and activity may not finish in time. This needs extra resource, or certain activities need crashing in order to reduce negative float value. When we have zero float value, it means that resources are just exactly sufficient to the complete activity. Any delay in any activity execution will now necessarily increase the project cost. And when we have a positive float value, which is when L minus E is greater than zero, it means that the project completion is ahead of the scheduled data. The resources are surplus, and these resources can be deployed elsewhere, or execution of the activity can be delayed. It means that we are running ahead of time, and if now any certain activity suffers a delay, we have that extra time to make the surplus. Important remarks are: the most important type of float is total float because it is involved with the overall project duration. The change in the value of total float changes the interpretation of the entire project duration. The value of free float may range from zero to total float and can never exceed the total float value, which means that total float is greatest of all three floats and free float is greater than the independent float. The lowest value we'll always have would be of independent float of each activity. The calculation of various float can help the decision maker in identifying the underutilized resources, flexibility in the total schedule, and possibilities of redeployment of resources depending on the value of the total float. Once the float of an activity is disturbed, the float of all other activities of the project is changed and should be recalculated. Friends, this was about the critical path method. And we have different floats when we calculate the different times, which we have learned. The three floats, namely the independent float, the free float, and the total float. Let us now try to understand the PERT technique, which was developed to handle projects of R&D mainly, where the time duration for each activity is no longer just a single time estimate, but it is a random variable that is characterized by some probability distribution using a beta distribution. The PERT model requires three time estimates for each activity to estimate the parameters of the beta distribution, which are mean and variance. So far we have been having just one time estimate for each activity, which we use to represent in a bracket next to the activity in the network diagram. But now we'll have more than one time estimate for each activity. The three time estimates are the optimistic time, the pessimistic time, and the most likely time. What does it mean by optimistic time, which is denoted by a small a or TO, where we have O in the suffix? It is the shortest possible time duration in which an activity can be performed, assuming that everything goes well, which means that under completely favorable circumstances, if all the activities can be performed, we have the optimistic time. Next, we have the pessimistic time, which means the longest possible time required to perform an activity under extremely bad conditions. This is when the circumstances do not go favorably in our favor. We have the pessimistic time, which is nothing but the longest time that is required to perform an activity. is denoted by TP or the small b. Next we have the most likely time, which is denoted by a small m or TM. It is the time that would occur most often or most frequently to complete an activity if repeated under same conditions many times. The expected or mean time of an activity denoted by TE or mu is the weighted average of all three time estimates, and it is given as T0 plus 4 times TM plus TP divided by 6, which is the weighted average. So to calculate the estimated time of any activity, we use this formula, which is T0 plus 4TM plus TP divided by 6. We also learn how to calculate the variance, which will help us to find out the probability of a completion of a project in a particular duration. The calculations of variance is based on an analogy to the normal distribution, where 99% of the area under normal curve is within 3 sigma limits from the mean or fall within the range TP minus TO, approximately 6 standard deviation in length. By this logic, we have standard deviation is equal to TP minus TO divided by 6. Sigma stands for standard deviation. So we can say that the variance of activity time represented by sigma square is nothing but TP minus TO by 6 the whole square. This is the formula we use to find out the variance of each activity time. The expected length of the project is the sum of all the average times of the jobs in the critical path. The variance of the project duration is sum of all the variances of the jobs in the critical path, assuming that the jobs are independent. So friends, when we have to calculate the project completion time, we add up all the variances and we add up all the times that it takes on the critical path, the activities that fall on the critical path only. The estimation of project completion time in PERT technique is useful in estimating the chance of completing the project in a desired time and the duration necessary for obtaining any desired probability of actually meeting the scheduled time. Due to central limit theorem, the probability distribution of times for completing an event can be approximated by the normal distribution. So by that theory, we have the probability of completing the project in the schedule or the desired time. TS is given by probability Z, where Z is equal to TS, which is the scheduled time, minus TE, which is the estimated time, divided by sigma, which is the standard deviation, where TE is the expected completion time of the project, Z is the number of standard deviations the scheduled times lie away from the mean or expected date, and sigma is the sum of standard deviations of critical activities. We add up all the standard deviations of critical activities and we get the resultant answer as the sigma. Let us have a look at the example. The various activities of small project and other relevant information has been shown in the adjoining table. The activities are 1 to 10 as shown in the figure. The question here is to not make a network. The question is, determine the expected task times and variance, the earliest and latest expected times, the critical path, and the probability of an event occurring at proposed completion time if original contract time of completing the project is 48 days. So we have 4 questions to be asked from this data. The data gives the following information about each activity. We can name each activity which is here given on the arrow 1, 2 as A, B, C and so on. It says that the most optimistic time for the first activity 1, 2 is 4, the most likely time is 8 and the most pessimistic time is 12. This information we shall always be given. With the help of this information, we are supposed to find out the estimated time of this activity 1, 2. With the help of the formula that we have just discussed few slides back. Using this information, we see that the formula to calculate the estimated time is given by TO plus 4 times TM plus TP, which is the pessimistic time, divided by 6, which is the weighted average. This is TE. So looking at the data of the question, for the first activity 1, 2, we have TO, TM and TP is 4, 8 and 12. Putting it in this equation, we have 4 plus 8 times 4 plus 12 divided by 6. So this is 48 divided by 6, which is 8. So the estimated time for activity 1, 2 is 8 days. Similarly, we can calculate the estimated time for activity 2, 3, where the optimistic time, the most likely time and the pessimistic time given are 1, 4 and 7. So when we put these values in the formula, we get the estimated time for activity 2, 3 is 4 days. And similarly, for all the activities as shown in the figure, as shown in the table. The table here shows the expected time, the fifth column, TE of each activity 1, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4 and so on up till the last activity, which is 6, 10. So far we have been having situations where we are given just one time associated with each activity. But in PERT, we have three time estimates, which are basically the optimistic time, the pessimistic time and the most likely time. We use all three time estimates finally to derive the total time estimated for each activity. Now, we also need to calculate the variance associated with each activity with the help of the formula, which we have derived with the help of normal distribution. As you can see, the formula to find out the variance sigma square is given by TP minus TO divided by 6 the whole square. This is the expected length of the project. The expected length of the project is the sum of all the average times of the jobs in the critical path. The variance of the project duration is the sum of all the variances of the jobs in the critical path, assuming that all the jobs are independent. So let us learn how to calculate variance with the help of the pessimistic and optimistic time. For the first activity, we have the optimistic time is 4, the pessimistic time is 12. We have to calculate sigma square. So we have 12 minus 4 by 6 the whole square, which when we calculate we get 1.78. Similarly, if we have to calculate the variance for activity 5-7, where we have the optimistic time as 3, the most likely time 6, and the pessimistic time 9, we put the values in the formula. We have 9 minus 3.6 square, which is 6 by 6 square, which is 1. So we have variance for activity 5-7 is 1. So if you have a look at this resultant table, we can see the expected variance for each activity starting from 1, 2, 6, 10. Respectively 1.78, 1, 1.78, 0.44, and so on. So we learned how to calculate the estimated time with the help of one formula, and we learned how to calculate the expected variance with the help of another formula. Now to answer the questions which we have been asked, this is the network diagram. We do not need to make it one more time, as we already have learned how to make. But with the help of this network, we observe that the critical path of this project is 1, 2, 4, 5, 7, 9, and 10. We can confirm it by looking at the earliest and latest times associated with all these activities. They are the same. 1, 2, 2, 4. We have 8, 8, 20, 20. And so on. So with the help of theory, it says that the expected project length is the addition of all the duration of activities lying on